الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، شفيع ذنوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا أبي القاسم محمد، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين غاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب. صدق الله العلي العظيم. اللهم صل على. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. My dear brothers, dear sisters, مؤمنين and مؤمنات، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. In the beginning, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all His blessings, His mercies, and His generosity upon all of us, day in and day out. And we also send our salutation and respect to our leader, our example, our Prophet al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. Allahumma sallam. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon him and his household, the chosen ones, the trusted ones, the most knowledgeable ones, the caliphs of the Holy Prophet, Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma sallam. May the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us among the true followers of the Prophet and his household, insha'Allah. Ibad Allah, one another day we are given to remind one another about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every Friday is another opportunity to remind one another about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwa Allah is the solution to all our problems. Any problem we may have in this life, the solution is taqwa. How so? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in Hadith al-Qudsi, Ya Abdi ati'ni taqun matan. My servant, be full obedient to me, and I will make you like me. Now, what does it mean Allah's going to make you like him? Are you going to be the second God? Another creator? No, Allah. The hadith didn't stop there. Then Allah said, أَقُولُ لِلشَّيْءِ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ وَتَقُولُ لِلشَّيْءِ. The power and the control that I have to tell things to be the way I want, I will give you that power. That the way things, if they're not going the way you want, with one word, you can turn it to the way you want. But the only way out is what? Taqwa. When you become an obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, then you get the power. Then you can change yourself. Then you can change things to the way you want. But بِشَرْطِهَا وَشُرْطِهَا. And the shart is taqwa. And that is why I'm saying that taqwa Allah is the solution to all our problems. Now if you go back to the Quran and you look at some of the examples, some of the people who are not even prophet, they were given this power. They were able to look at things and say be and not. And the reason is taqwa. May the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the taqwa, ya Rabbal Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters, the ayah we just read is in Surah Al-Hajj, ayah 32. And where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ. That indeed, those who glorify And those who take the rituals of Allah as something important, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِنَّهَا مِن تَقْوَى. What it does, it generates the fear of Allah in the heart. Now the ayah, if you look in the ayah, in Surah Al-Hajj, the ayah is talking about some of the rituals of Hajj that we do. And specifically about sacrificing. When people go to Hajj, one of the things we do is to sacrifice something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that when we sacrifice and give those meat to the needy and the poor people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let it be known to you and I that this is considered one of the glorification of Allah's rituals. Min sha'air. Now, what is the meaning of the word sha'air? Al-sha'air is the plural of the word sha'ira. Al-sha'ira in Arabic, what does it mean? Literally, it means alama, sign. That's what it means. So, when it says al-sha'ira, meaning it's a sign. Now, in Quran, Allah says, Inna safa wal marwa min sha'airillah. When you go between these two hills, one is called Safa, one is called Marwa, you going between them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's a sign of glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not about Ibrahim and Hajar, it's beyond that. Allah says, Inna Safa wal Marwa min sha'airillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, so this sha'ira meaning any alama or any sign that indicate about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's called sha'ira. Now, our mufassirin, they say al-sha'ira or sha'air. In Arabic, it means in Islam also that anything, any ritual that reminds you about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's called sha'ira. Now, whether be the sha'air in Hajj, or be any alama that reminds you about Allah in any part of the world, is called sha'ira min sha'air. And that is why our scholars out there define it. They said, al-sha'air Allah yashmulu jami' al-a'mal al-diniyya. Al-sha'air meaning any actions, any deeds in Islam, التي تذكر بالله سبحانه وتعالى, which reminds you about Allah سبحانه وتعالى وعظمته, and the greatness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. It's called Sha'ar. Now, so even though this ayah is talking about Hajj and sacrifice, but at the same time this ayah is talking about Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Now when we go to Hajj, we normally sacrifice an animal to home for the sake of Allah, so we can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, he sacrificed everything so he can become closer to Allah. So which means one of the greatest sha'ira min sha'airillah in Islam is majalis of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. That is one of the greatest of sha'air Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you and I will go to Hajj and follow the steps of Ibrahim alayhi salam to sacrifice those animals, and Allah calls that sha'ira min sha'air Allah. And Hussein alayhi salam, he sacrificed his children, his companions, and including himself for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What sha'ira can be better than this sha'ira of Imam Hussein alayhi salam? And that is why we wanted to emphasize about the importance of Muharram. And as you know, some of the places tonight, we are starting the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. But there are certain things, brothers and sisters, we need to know as we are approaching Muharram. Number one, the most important thing in the beginning, we need to understand the importance of the month of Muharram. That is the first thing. Now, how do we have to understand the importance of Muharram? You have to understand that Muharram is one of the Ashhur al-Hurum, one of the month that Allah chose to be holy. And that's why when you go to the Surah At-Tawbah, when Allah says, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِثْنَى عَشَرَ شَهْرًا مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةُ حُرُمٍ, Allah says there are four sacred months that He chose. They are considered holy out of the 12 months. Now if you go to the Tafsir, those four holy months are Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hajj, and Muharram, and then Rajab. These are the Ashhur al-Hurum that Quran talks about. And this month of Muharram and Dhul Qa'dah and Dhul Hajj has been known even from the time of Prophet Ibrahim. The holiness of this month didn't start with Rasulullah. Now it was even at the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam. It is mentioned in the history that during the time of Ibrahim, it was specified to be these 4 months. It was there before Ibrahim alayhi salam, but the Arabs, the people before that, they used to change it as they wish. They used to play around. Sometimes, every year they say, okay, this year, our 4 months, was considered sacred month, will be Rabi'ul Awwal and Dhul Hajj, and they will pick whatever they want. Then when Ibrahim alayhi salam came, Allah told him, Ya Ibrahim, these people are not to Allah, they're not allowed to play with those months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ya Ibrahim, what you need to do is to let them know that the holy months in the sight of Allah are these 4 months: Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hajj, Muharram, and Rajab. And it was specified from that. And when Rasulullah came also, the ayah was revealed, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِثْنَى عَشَرَ شَهْرًا مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we created 12 months in a year. Out of the 12, we chose 4 of them to be sacred. And one of them is the month of Muharram. Al-Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, he said, even at the time of Jahiliyyah, people used to respect the month of Muharram. They might be mushrikeen, they worshiping idols, but when Muharram comes, they pause every bad act that they used to do, just to honor and respect the month of Muharram. So the first one we have to understand, when Muharram comes, to understand the significance of this Muharram. Now, just to learn more about this Muharram, you go to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Allah says, I swear by the 10 nights. Now, what are those 10 nights that Allah is swearing by? There are two tafsir about it. The first tafsir says, it's the 10 days of Dhul Hajj, which one of those nights is the night of Arafah, the day of Arafah, the night of Tarwiyah. These are considered one of the 10 nights that Allah is swearing by. But then other tafsir also says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ is talking about the first 10 nights of Muharram. And this, from the Shia school of thought, this is much stronger. Why? Because in the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, the entire Surah Al-Fajr is known as Surah Al-Husayn salallahu alayhi wa sallam. This surah is known as Surah Al-Husayn. One of the companions of our sixth Imam came to Imam during the time of close to be Muharram. Then Imam reminded him about Muharram. And then he said to him, اقرأوا سورة الحسين. He said, do read the surah of Imam Hussein. The companion said, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, there is no surah that I know of which is known as Surah al-Husayn.
See, which surah is Surah Al-Husayn?
Then the sixth Imam says, Surah Al-Fajr is Surah Al-Husayn. Then the companion says, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, كيف تكون سورة الحسين وليس فيها آية تتكلم عن الجهاد?
I said, how can it be Surah Al-Husayn?
And the Surah Al-Fajr, from the beginning till end, there is no way it talks about jihad, sacrifice, nothing, none of that. Then Imam Ja'far says, أما قرأت قول الله? Haven't you read in this Surah, Surah Al-Fajr, where Allah says, يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
Haven't you read this?
He said, بلى قرأتها يا ابن رسول الله. Then Imam said in the hadith, فوالله, Imam Ja'far said, I swear by Allah, ما أنا أحدا إلا الحسين.
He said, I swear by Allah,
that this part, Allah didn't mean anybody but Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. So Surah al-Husayn is Surah al-Fajr. So if you want to understand the importance of this surah, you go to the surah, Allah said, Wal-Fajr, I swear by the Fajr, by the dawn. Now I'm not in tafsir of this ayah or this surah, but you know in the Quran we have tafsir al-zahiri and tafsir al-batini. Tafsir al-zahiri, yes, al-fajr is what, dawn. But tafsir al-batini, al-fajr huwa al-Husayn. How did Husayn become fajr? Al-fajr, dawn, comes after darkness takes over the entire part of the world. Then the day comes to uncover that darkness, to bring nur to mankind. Al-Husayn alayhi salam is the Fajr, because at his time the entire world is living into darkness.
And his sacrifice brought the light to mankind again.
And that is the Fajr that the surah is talking about. So al-Fajr is not just the dawn. No, that's the ma'na al-zahiri. Al-ma'na al-batini, al-Husayn alayhi salam. And if you want to understand this, you go to the history. And you see how people used to live. And when Imam Hussein sacrificed, how did that brought light to them?
Realize their responsibility. Realize how much they have wronged Ahlul Bayt. That is right after that sacrifice of Imam Hussein, Thawrat al-Tawabin started, Thawrat Ahl al-Hijaz started, Thawrat al-Iraq, Mukhtar al-Thaqif, all of them.
Now, that sacrifice of Imam Hussein brought the nur back to them.
And that is the Fajr from the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam.
So, when we say Wal-Fajr, these ayahs talk about Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So, one important lesson is when Muharram comes, you have to understand the importance of this month and the significance of this month in the sight of Allah. And that is number one. Number two, the second thing we have to understand also is Muharram and Safar is the month of sacrifice of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. That Imam Hussein and his companion and Ahlul Bayt, they gave the best of what they have.
Now you and I, we can sacrifice. We can give money. We can give our time. We can give our energy. We can volunteer. We can do many things as one of the sacrifices. But there is no way you can compare with what Imam Hussein sacrificed. So Muharram is the month for you and I to learn the importance of sacrifice for the pleasure of Allah.
Now the important part is, as the month of Muharram comes, I want to sacrifice, yes, but what is the best that I have to sacrifice? Because Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he has many things he can sacrifice,
but he chose the best of what he had to give to his creator. And remember the ayah tells you,
لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ.
Allah said, don't expect good from me unless you give the best of what you love. What is that I love? The most. Give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the ultimate sacrifice.
Now, I'm not asking you to go and sacrifice yourself like Imam Hussein alayhi salam, but there is every one of us, we can evaluate ourselves and see what can I do in the month of Muharram and Safar to sacrifice for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam.
And what is the best that I have that I can give in the name of Islam and in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That is it. And the most important lesson also out of the sacrifice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا.
They give,
they put others first, even if they also have need. And that is one of the simple sacrifices that we do, and especially in the month of Muharram.
That is number two. Number three, my dear brothers and sisters, as Muharram comes, we have to treat Muharram as the Shahrul Ibadah, and it's not a culture. Meaning what? A lot of us, when Muharram comes, it feels like it's a culture. That's something that we do every month or every year. When it comes, this is what I do. Routine, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm done.
Muharram is an act of worship and ibadah. That everything you do in Muharram, you have to seek the pleasure and nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Starting from the alim who sits on the minbar to the audience who participate to listen to the lecture.
The intention of alim who sits on the minbar, I'm sitting on the minbar to say words that pleases Allah.
The audience who come to the majlis, it's not a routine. Yes, I've been to majlis. I've been to all night of Muharram. I have been to 10 majlis a day. Yes, it's important.
But did you start to sort your niyyah to be qurbatan ila Allah? Don't focus on the quantity, but rather focus on the quality of the majlis.
Don't focus on, I've been to 3 in the morning. I've been running from one majlis to another majlis, another majlis to another majlis. So I left home at 5 a.m. I came home 12 p.m. Which is good.
But the most important is the niyyah of this majlis. And Imam Zain al-Abidin, salamullahi alayhi, salla ala. He teaches us how your niyyah should be in majalis of Imam Hussein. When he was taken to Sham in the castle of Yazid and he wanted to talk,
he said to Yazid, Ya Yazid, Ismahli an as'ada hadhihi al-a'wad.
Allow me to sit on these woods. And the wood, he means member. Remember, was made with food. He said, let me sit on this member. And then he said, لِأَقُولَ كَلِمَاتٍ لِلَّهِ فِيهِنَّ رِضَى. To say things that pleases Allah. This is for dua, for khatib,
for zakir, who sit on the member. When you sit on the member, your knee should be to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To say things that is within the line of Quran and Ahlul. Not to exaggerate things that has no reality.
Not to say things that is not there, just to make people to feel that, oh, I'm bringing something new, or I'm saying something nobody ever said.
Now you have to understand, Ahlul Bayt, they are great and they don't need you and I to lie to make them great.
They are who they are without the need of you and I to make up something.
Imam Hussein doesn't need me to make up something to add to his greatness. Whatever Allah gave him is more than I can even help in that. So tell people the real and what happened.
The truth and the true message of Ahlul Bayt.
That is for the member.
Now, the person who comes to listen, Imam Zainal Abidin says, وَلَهَٰؤُلَىٰ الْسَامِعِينَ
أَجْرٌ وَثَوَابٌ. And the audience also who come to listen, they also should also make a niyyah that I am going to this majlis, I am listening to this majlis, what? So that I can earn thawab and also get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So every majlis that you sit in, you have to make sure that you are going there as a qurbatan in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as an act of ibadah.
Because remember, that 1 hour, 45 minutes you sit in the majlis, Allah is going to ask you, Yawm al-Qiyamah, how did you use that time?
That time that Allah gave you
is a precious time Allah gave you. And you have to answer Allah, what did I do in that 1 hour? If I'm going to come to the majlis, sitting there, but I'm on my phone all the time, and I'm not listening to the majlis, right?
But I'm here. Yeah, my body is here, but my mind is not there. No, I go to the majlis, but I'm going to stand outside, smoking my cigarette, right? And having my, mashallah, good time with my friend, until the matter starts, then I come into it.
Okay. But you have to understand then, I'm not saying that you coming and standing outside is haram. No, no, it's
better you not to come. So come, stay outside. But one thing I'm going to tell you,
you can never think the thawab of a person sitting in the majlis and the thawab of a person standing out will be equal. That is something to keep in mind.
A person who's standing in the majlis for a 30 minutes, for an hour to listen to that majlis and attentively learn something, he or her thawab
is not compared with the person who comes and stands outside. Now it's your choice to make. I can stand up, I can walk in to sit there and listen.
That is
another thing we have to understand. And the last, not the least, brothers and sisters, this majalis is supposed to be recharging time and also reconnecting with Ahlul Bayt.
You know, your phone on your iPad, iPhone and iPads, after a long time of using it, at some point, the battery will drain, right? So what do you need to do?
You need to plug it back so that it gets recharged, so it can get back to work some more time. Muharram is the time to recharge our love and loyalty to Ahlul Bayt.
That's what Muharram is. So when the Muharram comes, I have to sit in the majalis, listen to the majalis, make use of majalis, and don't come to majalis as, no, I'm coming to the majalis because I'm just coming. Yes, I have to be there anyway. No,
you come with the spirit, I want to learn something. I have to take something out of this majalis.
As a matter of fact, especially for those of us who are parents, when you come, make sure that your child comes very prepared. Paper and pen, listen to the majlis.
What did you take from the majlis?
Discuss this majlis with your children in the car, at home. What did you hear from the Maulana today? What did you learn from him? What did you hear new? Is there something you didn't understand? Is there something you learned? Something.
That is how you make a difference in your life in those majlis of Imam Hussain. Not just to come in and out. Listen and just walk out. No, brothers and sisters. We need to take something more from the majalis of Imam Hussain alayhi salam. If your last year majalis and this year majalis becomes equal, I guarantee you, you are a loser.
If last year majalis, whatever you heard, didn't make a difference in your life, and this year were equal, then you are a loser.
And this is from the Prophet, مَنْ تَسَاوَى يَوْمَا فَهُمَا. If any person's yesterday and today is equal, then he or she is a loser.
A mu'min,
your today must be better than yesterday.
And tomorrow should be better than today.
And that is how a mu'min is supposed to be. Whatever I learned last year, I should learn more this year.
Progress, spiritual, closeness to Allah.
Then your majalis becomes more fruitful. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we get to benefit from this majalis, Ya Rabbi Alam. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to earn the highest and the maximum thawab in these nights of Muharram, Ya Rabbi Alam. Ya Allah, we ask you this Muharram at its beginning tonight. Ya Allah, we ask you, give us the best understanding of Imam Hussein and Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. And give us the tawfiq to serve them Ahlul Bayt in this month and every month, Ya Rabbi Alameen. And Ya Allah, do not deprive it from Muhammad and Ali Muhammad, Ya Rabbi Alameen. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wal asr inna al-insan lafi khusr illa al-lazina amanu wa amilu s-salihat wa tawasaw bil-haqi wa tawasaw bil-sabr. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Sallu. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين ثم الصلاة والسلام على حبيبه المصطفى أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل وسلم على علي أمير المؤمنين وفاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين ثم الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة أجمعين اللهم صل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين زين العابدين ومحمد بن علي الباقر علم النبيين وجعفر بن محمد الصادق وموسى بن جعفر القاضم وعلي بن موسى الرضا ومحمد بن علي الجواد وعلي بن محمد الهادي والحسن بن علي الأسكري والحجة بن الحسن المهدي اللهم هؤلاء حججك على عبادك بهم نتولى ومن أعدائهم نتبرأ إلى قيام يوم الدين اللهم اشرنا معهم في الآخرة وارزقنا شفاعتهم يوم القيامة إنك سميع مجيب. My dear brothers and sisters, one of the events of this week, as you know, as we mentioned, is the beginning of Muharram. There are so many things we can do in the month of Muharram, especially in the first night. One of the mustahabbat, which is recommended, is when a person comes to the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, wearing a black is one of the mustahabbat. There is a book that is written called Lubsus Sawad, wearing black, and the importance of it in the days of Muhammad. Now, it's not wajib, but it's mustahab, especially for those who want to attend the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. That is one of the recommendations. Now, another recommendation, one come to the majalis of Imam Hussein bil waqar, which means with the honor and respect you have in mind, I'm going to participate in the majlis or azadar of Imam Hussein. That spirit can make a big difference as you sit in that majalis. That is number two. Number three, once you try to refrain, especially during the first night, anything that is about happiness. Because remember, these are the days that the Prophet and Ahlul Bayt are born. And if you are their true followers, you should join them in the team. Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, in Hadith al-Kisa, Rasulullah salim, inni silmun liman salim, wa harbun wa adawun. Whenever Ahlul Bayt are in sorrow, the Prophet is in sorrow. Allah is in sorrow. When Ahlul Bayt are mourning, we also have to mourn. So in the month of Muharram, that should be the spirit. Anything about happiness, buying something, getting into business, something to make myself happiness. No, I have to create that mourning system, mourning environment in my house and every elsewhere. And especially for our children to learn to understand the importance of this night. These are things you have to keep in mind. And I hope we're doing this, we can create that environment that we can help ourselves and help our children and families, inshallah. And more importantly, gain the best reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these days of azab. May the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. and give us that reward, Ya Rabbi Alameen. The second also is about tragedy that is happening in Kentucky, where there is a flood that took the life of almost 16 people so far. Many, many houses gone. Properties are destroyed. It's a very devastating situation. Our heart and prayers goes to all those citizens of that part of the country, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help them in this difficult moment and difficult time. And this is a great cause, brothers and sisters. For anybody who can get to help, please do help. Because there is a lot of people who have lost so much. They need your help. Any little thing you can do, don't worry about whether they're Muslim or not. In Islam, helping the needy has no title. As long as you can help, help anyone. And that is the teaching of Islam. Because they need it. Our prayers and thoughts goes to all of them, Ya Rabbi Alameen. And also, it happened in St. Louis as well, where people also have experienced some of the damages, houses, cars, because of the non-stop rain for days. There is a lot of devastation also in that part of the country. And our prayers goes to all of them as well. May Allah make it easy for all of them, Ya Rabbi Alameen. The third one also is in Philippines. They also experienced an earthquake, which also caused a lot of damages, a lot of loss of properties and lives as well. It's a very sad situation. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all humanity, Ya Rabbi Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our humanity, Ya Rabbi Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easier for all brothers and sisters, Ya Rabbi Alameen. There is a lot of tragedy, stress that is going on in the world. One of them is about our brothers in Somalia who are going through a very, very difficult time. And we mentioned this before, and it was a reminder. Please help. For those of us who can do, you know, find a good organization who are very loyal and good that can help those people who are in need to do something for them. And that is very important, brothers and sisters. And the last, not the least, we're still praying about our brother who is now in jail in Dubai, that we talked about him last week. There are still a lot of effort are being done to help this brother. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of mu'mineen and mu'minat who are detained for wrong reasons, Ya Allah, bring them home and release them, Ya Rabbi Alameen. Ya Allah, all brothers and sisters who are going through difficulty across the world, make it easy for all of them, Ya Rabbi Alameen. In our community, there are people who are going through difficulty, sicknesses, lack of job, financial stress. Some of them, one other reasons that we don't know of. Ya Allah, you know better than us. Make it easy for all of them, Ya Rabbi Alameen. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna atainaka al-kawthar fasalli rabbika wal-har. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.